You might be wondering how I knew that I'd need four columns and three rows. Before I ever go to InDesign, the first thing I do is some planning. In this case, I collected the information, the images, and the text that we're going to use, and I also created some wireframes to help place that content. Initially, I did have seven spices, and as you can see, I considered two different options, and then realized that making it five spices would be a much better idea, and I've also come up with a layout that's going to be really effective. Our next step is to go ahead and add some images. To make this easy, we can lock the background and text layers and make sure that our image layer is visible. You'll also want to hide the background layer because that's going to make it easy to place our image frames. To place an image, we first need a frame, and we can simply drag the frames where we need them. We need to add image frames to match our proposed layout. If you'd like, you can use keyboard shortcuts to help you. So V is going to select things, and then I can go Alt Shift, and what that does is it copies and drags in line. I can also go Control C, Control V to get another box, and I can carefully place it. I can go Control V because I do need two more boxes. One will be here at the bottom left hand side, and the other one will be there. Some of my frames don't quite line up, so I'll zoom in by going Control Plus, and I can then move the frame so that it matches the margins that we set up earlier. We can resize boxes where necessary by moving the little white squares. If you push space, it will give you the little hand that lets you move around the image, and you can make sure that all of your frames are actually lining up with the grids exactly as intended. Once you're happy, you can zoom out by going Control Minus. Our next step is to put those images in. To do that, go to the folder that has the images, and we're going to use Control Click to select all of the images that we need. I can then drag, and you'll notice that there's a little five, and I can place each image very carefully in a text frame. Now at this point, the images don't look all that great. And if I go on my direct selection tool and I click on one of them, you'll notice that there's actually a huge image lying behind it. To fix this issue, I'm going to right click and I'm going to choose fitting. Then I'm going to choose to fill the frame proportionally. We want to do that for each of the images. So right click, fitting, fill frame proportionally. The shortcut for this is Control Alt Shift C. In the case of our turmeric, I actually don't want the image to be quite that small. So one of my options is to go back to that tool, click on it, and I'm going to make it bigger. And you'll notice that whilst the image gets bigger, it still stays within the frame. And I can even move it around a bit. I can play with it and make it slightly smaller. And I can place the image in a way that's going to make it really attractive. In the next video, we're going to go ahead and start to add some text.